Hey, what's up, guys? Welcome back to another episode of Let's Talk. Here's the question. During this whole pandemic, what are some of the best ways that you've seen to handle stress in the ministry field? If you don't know already, I'm a pastor. I'm an associate pastor here in Spartanburg, South Carolina. And one of the ways I can say, I'm going to speak from my experience. I would say during this season, we've been using that stress to actually innovate. And I personally love the fact that I'm seeing churches all over the world actually allowing the stress to create and make something good. The Bible says that all things work together for the good. So we're taking this situation at large as a body of people, and we're using it to bring impact and to bring glory to God. God didn't send COVID, but he can definitely use COVID for his glory. And so I personally would say some of the best ways I've seen is that. Another great example just from our ministry is that we've given an extreme amount of grace to every department because we understand that these are uncharted waters. Nobody from in our generation or our ministry at this time has ever seen something to this scale when it comes down to airborne disease and things that have impacted and moved the church into almost a season of isolation as far as physical gatherings. The church is still alive and well, but as far as being able to gather together in a room and to be able to worship together and to build community in that way, community has been shifted. And so we've been finding unique ways. I also believe in the church at large, I feel like it's helping in this way, that it's removing this procrastination from some churches to actually plow forward into unknown territory. You know, for some, you know, social platforms, social media has been something that many have created a sense of disdain around. And so now people are actually seeing that God can use that as a force to create something beautiful, to still maintain community. I mean, imagine if FaceTime didn't exist right now. The lack of ability to be able to see people that you really love and really care about. So I believe God's just using it to find another way to still empower and impact his people. The enemy can try to stop the kingdom. The kingdom suffers violence, but the violent take it by force. Hope that answers your question. Again, guys, if you have not already, visit the link in my bio. Send me your questions in leadership, marriage, relationships, whatever. I'm all down for it. Love y'all. Peace.